Francis Say Hi and Jesse Dangerous Lee Lou. Two middle-aged indie rap activists with far-ranging enthusiasms and inscrutable hairstyles, digging deep into the hard science of probability and what their friends are up to lately. This week, they plunge into the darkest corners of the mind and life of Choke-U-L-E's rapper, vegan, comedian, recluse, tender, friendly, boy band man. Keen to speak of what could be, what never was, and what remains to be seen. This is Imaginary Wednesday.
Oh.
Oh my goodness gracious me.
Young Jesse.
Jesus, is that you?
You sounded like C-3PO there.
Because my metal body wasn't fast enough to get one past you, friend.
Wow.
James, it's been a dog's age.
Yeah, it's been a whole week.
I'm sure dogs are born every week.
It's not a very old dog.
Puppy?
How you doing? I want a puppy. I'm looking for puppies. I signed up to buy puppies recently. Ooh.
Oh, that's good. You'll get some help digging that trench in your yard.
Dude, I've been digging trenches like crazy. Yo, we have
Well, that's a little bit of locker room talk. I'm not sure.
I'm sweaty. I feel weird. I've been digging trenches all week to put in the internet line so I can do a Christmas special, Astral Island Christmas special with Mean Joe Tunes and DJ Gripsky and some special guests. Jesse, you might know one personally. If you look in the mirror. Yeah, we got some homies on the show, but this Saturday at 3 p.m., we're going to be doing the Enter Astral Island Xmas Special. It's going to be fun.
Is it going to go on for a long time?
Hey, we're going to go till we can't go. But we have beer sponsorships, we have food and music and live music and DJing, and we're going to be doing art. We're going to do the spray arts, the anger graffiti.
Wait, who eats the food?
Me.
Is the food for the viewers? Can we download the food? Can we torrent it?
Yeah, you got a 3D food printer? We got you covered.
Probably.
Or maybe COVID. Well, I don't know. It's coveted or COVID?
Coveted.
I don't know. No one knows anymore.
Thou shalt not COVID your neighbor's wife.
Damn, son.
I'm glad to hear you're going to have a party this weekend. I'll see if I can make it.
Oh.
You know, light up the joint a little bit.
Hey. Someone else will be lighting up the joint a little bit, if you know what I'm talking about. And it's not just our next guest, who I'm very excited to announce. Uncle Festorius is going to graffiti, he says. Oh, yeah, so we do have Choke. We have Chokeylees. He's sparking joints all the time.
That's what, yeah. Hence, I heard that's how he got his name.
Well, I know how he got his name.
A rap battle on 8 Mile. And they started chanting it.
Hell yeah. But you know where it came from, dude? He used to be called the Smoke Eater. This is the story I know. His graffiti name was Choke. He was a graffiti writer in my hometown, the London, Ontario. And that was his graffiti name. Word up to the cops. I know they're listening. So whatever. Fuck you. ACAPS.
I'm
a
cop, like KOPS. Like.
Oh, those guys are cool, though. Don't worry about them. That's a graffiti crew. And then Choke was a bad boy in town that I rapped with, and he was part of Toolshed, and we all used to kick it. And then he was writing graffiti, but he used to smoke so much weed, they used to call him the Smoke Eater. And then I think his name, maybe I'm wrong. We'll have to get him after the green room to confirm the story. But then, as far as I know, the name went from like Smoke Eater Choke to Smokeylees. And then Chokeylees. That's what I got from, but I was often just around those guys getting a contact high.
Right.
Swear to God, Mom, just from hanging out. From being nearby.
Just from the ebullience of their personality. It's not a contact weed high. It's a just like a high on life. Contact high on life.
Yeah, it was vibing off the auras.
Well, that's, again, a little bit of locker room talk. But why don't Joel's got a choke in the back room somewhere. Joel's going to produce choke for us.
Joel's choking something in the back room, I'll tell you that. But I don't know if he's got our pal from the back burner, Swamp Thing posse. Hey, wait a minute. I want to show you something first. Wait, before we bring out Big Choke. Yeah. Hold on. Look at this. Look at this. I found this today. Let's see if you can see this on the internet. Here's a picture of Choke and Jesse D, the first time you guys hung out properly, and it's inside the old tool shed. And I remember I was hanging out, and tool shed was like, "Why'd you bring these guys to my house? Oh, they're weird." And then I left for like 30 minutes. I came back, and you guys were like writing rap songs and laughing and, you know, patting each other on the back, and it was so. Yeah. You guys became friends, and albums were born. That's a photo speaking of proof. Like,
it's proof. As we always speak of lost music, that posse cut that we were writing in that photo,
lost.
I have such an idealized recollection of it. I mean, we all got paired up. Well, I don't want to get too deep into it. We should bring Choke. Let's
do it.
Play, while Joel digs up Choke from the earth or wherever he is, let's hear a little
play
bit
one of the songs
from his new album.
Okay, which one are you thinking?
Wake up and fight.
Wake up and fight. Okay, we'll play this. Joel! Get Justin! Get Choke! All right, I don't know. I don't know if he can hear me, but I'll just start playing this. We'll eventually come in. We got Doc. Yo, Kira says what's up. Fucking Wade says what's up. Okay, Uncle Fester says what's up. The Mansta says what's up. Check out your new puppy. Show us the puppy, goddamn. Okay, here we go. Here's Choke's song. All right.
Yeah.
Joel!
Hands up like a clock at midnight. Time's up, that's the cost of this life. Yeah. Shut up while I'm rocking this mic. Get your shot when I fall off. Sit tight. You turn the lights out. I think I need to lie down. By now, the medicine is setting in and everything I've ever done is telling me to hide out. By
now, this guy can rap.
Sitting in a dark room. It helps me develop. I'm eating all these mushrooms. I'm living in a cartoon. We overanimate, phased by the gamma rays. Bruce Banner doing stage banner with a stand-up bass. But I can't complain. Another blank canvas in a can of paint. Yeah.
Make up your mind, wake up and fight.
Pagliacci, Pagliacci. Ali Ali oxen free. Toxin free, so no oxy, please. But if you got some weed, then come talk to me.
So dope.
Pagliacci, Pagliacci. Ali Ali oxen free. Run DMC, Spuds McKenzie, sting like AB, as you can see. Two-time dropout, none can test me. College, uni, unimpress me.
Oh, here he is, here he is.
College whips ass.
Yo.
Skip class. I've been holding myself back. I want them big bucks, that Brinks truck. I'm flat broke and piss drunk. On that note, no stigma, whatever dogma. You dig ma, into me like King Tut. Bejewel me, all blinged up. Pandora won't swing shut. Better shake off that ring rust. Feel no pain, nothing matters. Window pane, fucking shattered. Kirk Cobain, cardigan, sweater. Purple rain, pink polka dot umbrella. Dummy, but I'm slick. Ugly, but I'm quick. Double down on the hand I was dealt. No doubt I'm about to get money on the bed.
Make up your mind, wake up and fight.
Yeah.
Make up your mind, wake up and fight.
Pagliacci, Pagliacci. Ali Ali oxen free. Toxin free, so no oxy, please. But if you got some weed, then come talk to me. Pagliacci, Pagliacci. Ali Ali oxen free. Talk is cheap, but these thoughts are deep. I don't squawk a peep, I speak prophecy. Public enemy, human centipede. Butterfly float, no amphetamines. Jet fuel can't melt no metal beams. Don't nobody know what meta means. Double cross frame within a frame. Albatross dangling from the chain. Bubble hash flavor hits the flame. And the vapors hit your brain.
Smoke. Make up your mind, wake up and fight.
Oh.
Make up your mind, wake up and fight.
I couldn't care less about nepotism, but I'm loving the debate. Great minds battling it out, and I've got a front row seat.
Yes, dude.
That sets up the whole show. We're going to battle it out.
Hey, guys.
Hi, Joke. What up, man?
Yo, James, I got sours for tonight in honor of, I was watching the first and second episode. Saw you enjoying some sours.
Hell yeah, man. You changed from ciders to sours, huh? Because we were drinking lots of cider. Yeah.
Nothing's constant, but James, right?
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
Start over.
Yeah. Rewind. Yeah, I'm drinking. I'm drinking a porter tonight. I'm drinking a porter right now from Beer Labs, London, Ontario Brewery, right downtown. These are the homies. They're supporting the show. I've been always drinking their ish, and now I love to drink it while I am talking to you guys. I'm a few in because I've been drinking with the guys who are working on my house, which is not a good idea. But I did it. So, yeah.
Oh, it's the best idea. You're like, yeah, man, this is amazing. You guys killed it. Go home early.
Next day, roof's caving in. I just want to give a shout out to Bill Miller Barbecue in Texas, where I got this fine souvenir cup from. It's full of water and ice. But I didn't bring the water back from Texas. Just the cup was empty, and I filled it again when I got it home. Saved a bunch of money.
Hey. Speaking of slanted houses, do you remember my house in Halifax that I lived in that was totally slanted on Creighton and Falkland? And
for those of you in Chibuktik there, it was that famous house that was upstairs from a closed store.
Yeah. Yeah, it was a crazy house. It was cool.
6'2" lived there. Graffiti writer who was at the time called Tonto lived there.
Yeah.
Tonto.
Yeah. It was a graffiti sleepover camp. It was dope.
I feel like we're having a sleepover.
Totally, dude. Totally. Hey, yo, we got a lot of people on here. Thomas Quinlan, Han Solo Records. He's saying you guys should interview some Han Solo artists. What are you talking about?
Chokulis?
Yeah. All
and
of us?
Fucking... Also, the Mighty Rhino.
Yeah, and us.
And
Fess is in the building.
Fess is in the building. Kara's in the building too. Yo, yeah, is that Larry Bird?
Decided whether they're signed to Han Solo yet or not. It's a bidding war.
Yeah, exactly. Hey, Larry Bird, I love the album you made with Choke. Hey, it's really great. Congratulations to both you. We need more Justin. Should I cancel actually the background music so we can get more Justin? Because just to get the volumes. Do you have headphones, Joe? Do you have headphones?
Do I own a pair?
With a mic on him?
Or are you broke?
Okay. All right. We'll do this without any background tunes.
I'll just get right in here and be like, yeah.
That's what I'm talking about. Yeah, we got our homie Choke on here. Choke, as you know, the show is kind of a little bit about, not a little bit, it's completely about things that were imaginary, that never really made it to the final album. Or, oh, Jesse, you got something to say? Your hands up.
Wait. Wake Up and Fight. The song we just heard from Nepotism.
Yeah. That's what, yeah.
It's from something.
Well,
and we
all disagree. It doesn't.
We want you to clear it up.
Yeah, I did tell Jesse about Wake Up and Fight that we just listened to. Is the second last track on Nepotism, produced by Larry Bird, who's hanging out in the comments, my cousin. And Wake Up and Fight is actually from Woody Guthrie's 1942 list of 33 New Year's resolutions. There's all these ones that are like, I don't know, they're amazing. Like, learn people better, take bath. And the last one, number 33, is Wake Up and Fight. And Larry Bird, the OG, is number 33. So it was like a little weird inside nod to Larry.
Choke.
But it's a little inside baseball, but it's just because there might have been microdosing involved in writing that song. So
it's inside basketball, I think, technically.
Yeah, I think Larry Bird played
that. Oh, nice one.
It's kind of a sports commentary show now, I just thought.
But yeah, there's a few nods to weirdness in that song.
Choke, you're always breaking down shit like that. You're always breaking it down like that. It's like it means something on five levels. Always with this guy. Holy shit.
No, sometimes when I'm talking with Chocules, we both get headaches because there's like the riffs are too fast and it's really irritating.
Your noses start bleeding.
That's the number 33 resolution of 1942. What's your number 33 resolution of 2021 coming up?
My New Year's resolution, I made it back in September. It was to try and do things early.
See? He did it again!
He prepared that joke early.
Dude, how the fuck? Yeah, you son of a...
Speaking of early, and speaking of what James is about to say, some things happen. Like, Justin's been putting out... Chocules. I'm not going to tell you his real name. Chocules has been putting out records.
Anyone still confused out there?
For 25...
Get them sounds out. Anything close to Chocules, I'll respond.
Chug-a-lug.
Chocuelis.
Chug-a-lug.
Chocuelis.
Count Chocula.
Count Chocula.
Like, okay, Choke's been putting out records for a long time. Solo records with his old group Toolshed, his current group Swamp Thing, part of the Backburner crew. And, like, you know, we all develop many ways. And there was a record that he was putting out on Han Solo, I think, like 11 years ago. And there's, like, some stuff got cut from it, right? Not everything made it out. There's remnants of realities that were never traversed, right?
Hypergraphia, you're talking about? I guess the first song, the song over the Fester beat that we're going to share with people, it might have actually been like just after Hypergraphia, and because it was like 5 years from anything else happening, it just sort of got lost in the shuffle. But yeah, like one of the songs, I think the first one we're going to share is Quits.
Yeah.
And it's a song I made with Fester, and he threw me a dope beat. He's got some dope cuts on there, but then it just never came to fruition. And part of it was my fault, just not digging the rhymes. It's essentially like written like a breakup song, but it's about cigarettes. And it's like when I was trying to quit cigarettes for the umpteenth time. 2 years quit now, though. Bang, bang, bong, bong.
Dope.
This was like 2009 writing a, like, you know, a breakup song about cigarettes. But if you don't know that, it just kind of sounds like a shitty song about a breakup that's like crappy. So it was a fault of mine in the writing. And then I realized it was just kind of I Used to Love Her by Common Sense, but flipped differently. So
which is also about smoking.
My contribution is enough to put it out at the time, but it's worth hearing because Fester mucked it up.
That's dope. We got Fester on here too in the chat, and Uncle Fester's going to be a guest later on too. That's fucking awesome, man. That's dope.
Yo, Larry Bird says, I'm about to smoke a cig in honor of you. I hope that doesn't like set you back. Do you have to start counting again?
Oh, yeah. No, he's still young and beautiful, so he can he's still in the he's allowed to damage himself more.
He's invincible still. Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah. Well, can we
whatever you want.
Yeah. As he sparks another. Should we hear this track?
Yeah, let's check it out.
So I want to hear that. I've never heard this.
So this is 2009, I believe. And I didn't talk to Tim today, but he's got a way better memory for stuff like that. But my MacBook told me it was 2009. So I think it was right after Hypergraphia. And like I said, there wasn't really a project to attach it to. This was kind of the demo. I would like to have think had it come out, I would have like improved upon the my own rhymes. But I think it's still good enough to look back on. And let's go, James.
All right, let's do it.
Roll down.
Uncle Fester, I fucking love Uncle Fester.
And don't waste your time. 'Cause you know that I've been thinking about you day and night. For so long, if anything was wrong, you made it right. Even now, while I write this, you're right here. Soon the tension in the air will be quite clear. It's over, and of course it's been over. You on my lips like kissing a poisonous cobra.
Damn.
And the poison was potent. So what's the point of this moment? These repetitive motions. Petty devotion to a bad addiction. You don't get me high, all of it's habit driven. I'm past the wishing that fact was fiction. Realizing you and I have had sufficient. It's been said before, lasted a few months. Me coming back is exactly what you want. But not this time, so let's get together. Just once more, then call it quits forever. No, I don't need you. Can finally see through this cloud of deep blue.
And don't waste your time.
Said I don't need you. You're in my rear view. Still hardly seems true.
I'm not straight
in. Waste your time.
Cause you know that it's too much for me to sacrifice. Another year and I've been hooked on you for half my life. Gotta let you pass me by, dodge the bullet. Learn not to deal with your toxic bullshit. Will I survive without you in my life now? Who knows? Only one way to find out. I'm out, this relationship destructive. Go find somebody else's heart to fuck with. I just wish we'd never been introduced. Telling others if they ever run into you to keep running. You're pure evil. Heard you harm babies, torture animals, and hurt people. And I ain't saying you're a gold digger. You're a fucking money pit and a stone cold killer. So good riddance, this needs to end. Now get out of my face and let me breathe again. No, I don't need you. Can finally see through this cloud of deep blue.
And don't waste your time.
Said I don't need you. You're in my rear view. Still hardly seems true.
And don't waste your time.
If you can't get with it, then get gone, gone, gone.
Forget it. And don't waste your time.
Yeah.
Forget it. And don't waste your time.
If you can't get with it, then get gone, gone, gone.
Forget it. And don't waste your time.
All you want me to do is do it blazing crazy.
Forget it. And don't waste your time.
Yo. So good. So
yeah,
good.
Shout out Fester.
Shout outs to Uncle Fest, man.
I'm a little bit alarmed. Like, I like that it's a song about not smoking. There's a Rakim cut in it, but it's not no cigarettes. Know what I mean?
Because I don't want to give away the sauce. And I've been smoking like 1 year from half my life or something. So it means I was 29. So I wrote it in 2008. So yeah, probably it was 2009 at the latest when I recorded it. But,
right. That's the math. Did you play it for anybody who ever like misunderstood what you were like, hey, this is a bad song about like a breakup. This sound, get out of my face.
Yeah,
Saibo
was like, oh yeah. Like I kind of half heard it was like, whoa, I thought he got along with all his like ex-girlfriends. Like what's up with that? And yeah. I was like, yeah, that's the, you know, so it was like, if it went over like one of the homies' heads, I didn't love it what I'd written anyway, but, should have repurposed it and not just shelved it for good, because the hook and the cuts come out nice.
Totally,
that's,
man.
All right.
Sorry, go ahead. You go. You're the guest.
I was just jokingly going to say it doesn't have as much of like a story. No spoilers, because I want people to catch up on the other episodes. But like when one of your guests' problem is like, oh, I had a song, but it sounds too much like a smash record.
Right.
Loved, so I had to shovel it. Mine's a bit of a different story. It's just like, oh, here's something that didn't come out. But luckily we've been making good shit long enough that even the B-sides are worth checking out sometimes.
Definitely. I think it's a great song, man. I mean, personally, like, you could put it out there.
Yeah, well, Fester gave it to me with that, like, hand. You know, the chorus is right there, call and response with the sample. So he just kind of handed it to me. Maybe I dropped the ball a little bit, but looking back, it's, you know, it's better than maybe I gave it credit.
He was like, I really think you should quit smoking. It was, that's how he staged an intervention. He was like, I got this beat for you. And I want you to take better care of yourself.
He's like, hey man.
I got a song on the awards album, called Ink or Paint. And, so we have like a, thanks, homie. We have, it's funny actually, because we have two videos. One actually, water shot of me on this train bridge, and then I repurposed old footage of living in Halifax that I made for a thing with 6-2 back in the day with some of 6-2's beats and one of Jesse's beats. That's a whole other thing. But the ink or paint. And then we did a live version in Jesse's living room with Jesse playing. Which drum were you playing? It's got Jesse, Mean Joe Tunes, and Liz is in the background hanging out, and Funkin's on the piano. And I was sick.
Yeah, I had a lap snare and a tom-tom.
Yeah, maybe it was really...
Oh, Joey was shaking... Joey was shaking his whiteout marker.
Yes, that's right. He was shaking a marker, which
hit
is...
up Anthony's pizza place around the corner from me.
That's right. We did some graffitos in your hood, homie. But shout out to Mean Joe Tunes, the fucking booze hound. But but that video, it went out there, and a lot of people, because you can really hear the vocals in it and stuff. And people, it's a song about my obsession with an artist, not my obsession necessarily, but like any artist who really wants to hit a surface, a graffiti writer wanting to write on a surface. And I was kind of thinking about like the Police song, like Every Step You Take, and it's a super problematic song, but I kind of wanted to write something almost being problematic in that way too, right? But like not necessarily trying to be problematic, but like the story's mysteriously hidden in there, and it's like I'm talking about like I drove by in my car and I saw you, or I was in a friend's car and I saw, and I want to touch the surface that I'm not allowed to, or I want, you know, like this kind of thing. And a lot of people in that live version were just like, great song, but the lyrics are a bit weird. And they're like, it's slightly problematic, but it's like just talking about trying to do graffiti. You know, I kind of knew there was going to be maybe a little bit of controversy there, but I didn't expect as much as it. Because the chorus is me literally saying, like, I like painting on things. Like, you know what I mean? Like, it's so obviously put out there. But people,
when we did that, that was in the middle of a tour. And when you played it on tour, you explained before you played it. And I think that was good. Like, I think giving people the context was good, because then they could appreciate the cleverness. And also, like, with this, you know, playing this Quits song, I like it more knowing what it's about, because I'd be bored if I thought it was about a weird relationship thing.
Yeah, or people would just, like, leave. You know what I mean? Like, or at least during my song, they'd be like, oh, this is, like, a fucking bad song. I'm going to bounce. You know what I mean? Or something. Lose a couple of your people in the crowd or whatnot. But
so my second release in the Rap Hundreds, which was like a resurrected song that I'd written around 2009, 2008 or 2009, like just after Verb of a Lot, it actually was like from the perspective of me trying to write from the perspective of someone who I thought was having a shitty breakup. And like I was writing it to like kind of take him down. Like I had a problem with the guy and I didn't like what I was writing. But once I had the song sitting for more than 10 years, and then like I would try to do it live and I was like, oh, how much explaining do I have to do at the beginning of this song before people are like, wow, this is not the way Jesse usually talks about relationships.
Yeah. Like, isn't the song supposed to be the explanation?
Oops. All metaphors.
Same, did the same thing. Because I see what Young Me was trying to do is like get progressively, like the second verse, it's not bad, it's not hardcore, but I'm still trying to be like angry or like, fuck you, I hate you. And it's just like, if you don't know that I'm talking about cigarettes, it just sounds like an immature, like, you know, like getting mad at a partner. Like, it's just, it's a weird thing.
Totally.
But not that bad. I mean, you know.
No.
When you start reading off of like a list of warnings from the cigarette package also, it's like, I heard that you like torture animals.
Yeah,
that's when people
see
like,
6% of like the population.
The good thing is I like that I'm with a crew of people that are this concerned about a song that they're writing about that is like actually has a different meaning that has nothing to do with like being a fucking creep, but we're afraid to put it out. But other rappers actually write straight up fucking creepy songs about horrible shit they want to do to their exes. Like fucking a bunch of losers. You know what I mean? I love you guys, by the way. That's what I'm trying to say.
Yeah. I'd rather be friends with us.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
Kira says, yeah, you guys are all uptight, politically correct feminist rappers. Get over it.
Never. Never.
That's a good point. Kieran's a good point. Let's get over
it. Yeah. Yeah. Let's get over it. Let's get under it. Let's get into it. Let's get into it. Let's get into another. Let's get into another choke song. That's an unreleased. What's up?
There's more choke songs that never came out. He's been holding out on us all this time.
There might be one or two, three others.
I believe the next one is just over a fluffer beat.
Hey now.
So
you might have to explain fluffer beats to the audience. Can you?
Sorry. So the next one is just over a random beat that isn't the beat for the song. I just had the idea one day, and so I went and found an industry beat to use to write a dope song to, or try to
get you hard.
To get me hard.
To fluff you up.
And then later on, had that gone on an album, I would have been like, "Yo, Tim, Buck Two, or Civilian, I wrote this to Akrite, Dr. Dre."
Now we're going to get canceled.
No, I used the beat. So this is the first time he's going to be hearing about it. And it was just an album or an idea I had when I was in between albums, and it didn't end up going anywhere, but it was just the Toxic Avenger, but Talk Sick instead.
Sick.
For anyone who writes rhymes, that's just like, we get it. What?
But there you are again. So
I was like, I'm going to tell the story of the Toxic Avenger, the movie, but I'll spell it Toxic. But that was it. It wasn't really anything that much deeper. And I just did it over that beat, just to have a demo. And then, we were doing so much, like, that was probably around when Swamp Thing started, like, really putting out shit around 2012.
Okay.
And so I just didn't put out a solo album for like 3 years, and it just kind of got lost in the dust. So it's just this weird choke song about Toxic Avenger over some Dr. Dre beat that you're all about to hear for the first time ever.
Heck,
so it's about
man.
Cigarettes?
Pardon?
It's about cigarettes?
I thought you said Deuce Bigalow?
You're going to tell the story of the movie Deuce Bigalow, Male Gigolo?
Yes.
Okay. All right.
I think this one.
Because I have it. There's not spoilers, is there?
But spoilers for the movie?
Yeah.
No comment.
Yeah, exactly. I think that's spoilers.
You don't want to spoil me on the song. You don't want to tell me ahead of time whether I'm going to get spoiled in the song.
There's nothing in the song you wouldn't know from watching the trailer to the movie or seeing the cover to the comic book.
So if you've seen Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Secret of the Ooze, you already know what's going to happen. So
he lives in a dump and he's toxic. What can I tell you?
Toxie was like, there was a Ninja Turtles figure of him, right? Like his action figure came out as part of the Ninja Turtles Playmates line.
Yeah.
Not Playmates like sexy, but.
I believe that. I believe
so
that.
Basically, this is a Britney Spears cover, right?
Yep.
Is that right?
It's talk. Yeah, this song is called "Toxic" by Britney Spears.
Take it away, Britney.
Toxic Avenger.
All right, here we go.
Shout out to Dr. Dre.
Ha ha. Shout out to Dr. Dre.
Fuck Dr. Dre.
Yeah, kind of fuck Dr. Dre. Yeah.
I was a nobody, so nobody gave me full respect. These words barely carried any weight, soaking wet. A geeky weakling who squeaked while speaking to bullies beefing and screaming mean things. Events of a recent evening left me reeling, then really steaming. After being humiliated rather badly, then chased by haters that were laughing at me. I dove headfirst through the second story window. Had to escape unscathed, but I didn't though. I fell below into a drum of green ooze. Nuclear waste is a waste to clean shoes. I emerged skin bubbling and burning. Concerned I was turning into something disturbing. Bursting into flames, I began to change. First it hit my brain, right then I became the Toxic Avenger. Defender of justice who crushes offenders. The Toxic Avenger. Watch center stage get mopped with contenders. The Toxic Avenger. Looks like my face got tossed in a blender. The Toxic Avenger. The Toxic Avenger.
Okay.
Yeah.
I must confess this next line is serious.
I'm pretty bummed to could be living in the city dump, wallowing in pity, thinking how am I gonna get these chumps. Screw the cops, to clean the streets I use a mop. All this shoot 'em up bullshit is loser talk. Guten Tag, you just got a wake up call. I'm going all out, that's the only way to brawl. You're going all in, it's up to you to make the call. I'll grab you by your next nape and make it taste the walls. Cold serve, my
nice.
The circle. Old enemies gather round in a circle. I went berserker, tore it to jerk's throats. Grab my mop and kill three with the first blow. One left, and we're going into sudden death. I didn't, but the bully never breathed another breath. The news says I'm a gruesome mutant, but true friends know I'm a superhuman. The toxic avenger, defender of justice who crushes offenders. The toxic avenger, watch center stage get mopped with contenders. The toxic avenger, looks like my face got tossed in a blender. The toxic avenger, the toxic avenger.
Like, I want to show this to Word Burglar fans, you know? Like,
yeah, yeah.
Yeah, Quentin just said, bonus song on the next Swamp Thing? It's definitely Swampy. Like, we were, I was pretty Swampy at the time.
What was your process for determining the perfect fluffer beat? Did you have the song first? Did you write it to this?
Yeah. How'd you come about that?
I can't remember. I think it was just I was downloading a bunch of acapella packs on like not LimeWire, but you know, like something like Pirate Bay, like old enough back then. And every now and then there'd just be an instrumental in there. I just had the Akrite instrumental in my iTunes. So I just kinda went through the beats I had for the tempo that I guess I was thinking of that day. And now Dr. Dre gets to say he made a song with Chocules.
Yeah, well, that could be your foot in the door to making a Toxic Avenger soundtrack.
But yeah, I did forget. I mean, that'll probably get you muted on Twitch, but on the real, fuck Dr. Dre and anything good he made, whatever. Fuck you forever. But that was 2012. And thanks for tuning in.
Yeah, exactly. Peace, Internet.
That's why we never put it out, is because we didn't want to work with him anymore.
But yeah, we're not up here saying he's not a goof.
We're not into his shenanigans, man. Fuck that shit.
Yo, I think it's a good time to remind people of what's coming up on Saturday. Thesis, do you want to just mention that again?
Yeah, definitely. So Saturday in the place, we got the on this channel, Enter Astral Island on Twitch TV. We are having it's called our Holiday Lockdown Special. The Holiday Lockdown Special! Featuring Mean Joe Tunes, DJ Grip Sky, or Grip Ski, and Thies Diesel. Coming to you live, 3 p.m. Saturday. But yeah.
3 p.m. Eastern.
Right.
So 5 p.m. in Osaka, right?
Yeah, right, word.
5 a.m.
3 p.m. Eastern.
The next day.
Yeah, exactly. 14 hours in Japan. So we're doing this thing. We're really stoked. I've been like working on my painting studio where I make my art, but I've been like, I used to have like a fire in there and it didn't really work very well, so I put in like a whole new heating thing to try and make it work. And I thought it would be cool to stream some shows, and it was supposed to be done like a month ago, but now I'm like trying to like hire extra people to come and like help put the heat in. And we did a lot of work today and get the internet back there properly. So yeah, I'm pretty stoked. It'll be a fun show. It'll be a fun hangout. And we have some guests coming in. Some of the back burner homies. Some of the London homies. Some homies in general. Some we don't know yet. People are going to be coming in and guesting in at the last minute. We're going to be doing it safely and sort of distanced. The three of us have been real careful as far as sticking within our bubble for the last couple weeks. So we're playing it safe. Yeah, so I'm real stoked. Check it out, 3 p.m. on Saturday. Choke, what are you sharing there, homie? Pinky Brewster, that's the dope name. The character's dope. The character's dope.
I like the can you had before.
I didn't want to interrupt. I'm just visual component.
I like the visuals, man. Yo, I got another visual for you too. I got another one.
He look away. This is disgusting when he does.
Nah, man, this one's cool. But, yo, remember the same time? Oh, go ahead.
Sorry, it doesn't matter. I was gonna say I got double devices going on, so it's hard to keep up with the comments. But shout out to everyone in the comments. Yeah. Sorry.
Yeah. No. It's cool. It's cool, man. We got to do that. Those are our people, man. Thank you, everyone.
Yo, Larry's shouting out the art behind you thesis.
Oh, dope. Thank you, Larry. You're fucking awesome, dude. That's
unless
dope.
He means the art behind Justin, we know that. Greater than me, so that'd be weird.
Or maybe he just means the frames, but either way, that's dope. I love you, Larry. I don't know.
When's the thesis episode of this show?
Every episode is a thesis episode.
Can we get him? Do you think, like...
I said to Fester earlier, schedule? I was like, this show is going to rule because it's just going to be all of us taking turns watching our homies hang out with Jesse and thesis every week. And this week's my turn.
If we could just do it with everybody at once, it would be dope, but I don't know if the internet could handle it.
We can barely shut up for 1 second now.
Yo, Kira's saying, can we ask the... guest a question? Yeah, of course. That's the whole point of this thing, homie. I'm gonna show this picture though too while you're doing it. Look, here's us all hanging out at Concrete Canvas at the same time when we recorded that posse cut that went to nowhere. Yeah. There's Kilgore wearing his cargo pants, Karg wearing the cargos. We got Cybo in the background. We got Choke grabbing his fucking dongle, and it's not about a MacBook Pro. And we've got Bluebird in the background. Bluebird. Look at these guys rubbing dreadlocks, these dirty hippies rubbing their dreadlocks.
Frank Deluxe
Cybo
there.
And
Cybo's there.
Frank Deluxe. We got Uncle Fest deep in there. We got me throwing up at H-Dub. We got Man Alive. We got Hemol, holy shit, from Florida. We got Jesse D being young all up in there. We got Timmy in the background. Yo, we got Spy Tech. We got Frank Deluxe, the other imaginary friend's friend, who's not really, he's just imaginary. That's why he's so blurry in the picture.
We got
hanging out. Concrete Canvas. Well, I don't even know what year that was. No, 2009, 1999.
It's under pressure. 2002.
2002. Trust your words. I trust your mind.
Under pressure, Montreal.
If you look at my hand, I'm holding the lyrics to this next song.
Oh, dang! What a segue.
Crazy, I don't want anyone to hear anything I made and recorded in 2002, actually.
Bluebird like Bluebird. Yes, Mike, we do mean Bluebird like Bluebird. All right. Carolyn has a question for the people who aren't me on here. Who is the best person in the world to text to talk you down if you maybe accidentally get too high?
Uh-oh.
What?
Is that what it says?
Yes, Kira is asking the question. It's a question for Thesis and for Chocules.
Okay.
Who is the best person in the world to text to talk you down if maybe you accidentally got too high?
Choke, can I go first? My answer's simple.
Yeah.
CBD. Smoke some more CBD because it'll actually level you out and make you feel fucking better. That's my quick answer.
Wait, you smoke CBD?
Yeah, smoke CBD every day.
Well, she said, who's the best person? I think the answer is me. Because someone may have messaged me allegedly and been like, yo, I'm super high off these edibles. What do you do? I'm the guy to ask.
Someone, you are the guy to ask.
The good news is, like, you're in the worst of it. So you're just high either way. So, you know, you can enjoy it or you can freak out. But, like, it's not going to get worse. And actually, I don't know what I said, but
that would be your advice right now if somebody asked you. That would be your advice right now if somebody asked you.
Like, my advice, whenever I get too high and for a second I'm like, uh-oh, then another part of my brain goes, this is what you wanted. And I'm like, yeah.
Yeah.
That was short-lived.
One time
we're going to clip that out for the for YouTube for this advice. Advice from Chocolate.
Marijuana ain't gonna destroy you, so unless it's your dog or your kid, don't worry about it. You're fine.
This just turned into a Joe Rogan episode. That's amazing. Okay. No, but yo, one time though, I smoked some shit I shouldn't have smoked, and then like I ended up like on some, this isn't the time I fucking blanked out at the that was interesting. That's a good story too. But one time at the ranch in LA, I smoked a bunch of crazy ish, and a bunch of my other homies smoked some shit we shouldn't have smoked, and I was just like, everyone's freaking out, and I was just like, my clarity thought was like, hold on a minute, man. All the other guys who just left the party all fucked up, who smoked that shit with us, they did it because they liked it. Can we just try and enjoy this and see what the fun part of it is? And then the night got really fun after that. I was just like, let's just let it be fun, you know? And it kind of worked. But yeah, that time I blanked out at the shed, that was amazing. I just didn't know where I was. Irate brought over that shatter, and I smoked that shatter. And that was when we recorded the song about cider, right? Yeah. And I was just... Yeah, he left me alone with that pen. He left me alone with that pen, and I kept smoking it. And he goes, oh, fuck, you shouldn't smoke that much. And I was like, oh, that's fine, man. I feel fine. And then I was like, where am I? Like, I felt totally normal. It's just that I couldn't remember a thing. I didn't feel paranoid or worried. I just didn't know. I was like, I'm in the tool shed, but what am I doing in Toronto? Like, why am I here? And then, like, civilian had to, like, take me. He had to call a cab and irate. And like put me in the cab, and I was like, they're like, where are you going? I was like, I don't even know.
You were walking around Tim's house holding your phone with like a charger hanging out of it, but like,
yeah. My mind just went blank. Like, I wasn't worried. I wasn't passed out or anything like that. It just disappeared. I was like, what? And they were like, well, do you know your friend's name where you're staying? I was like, I think so. I like, went to my phone. They're like, do you know the address? Yeah, it's right there. Went down to the cab. They still had to show the cab driver the address because I didn't even know how to do that. Anyways, that was interesting. That's a whole other thing.
It's because the pen was like wild-ass concentrates of like Ward's, Primo, whatever he's smoking, and you just started hitting it like it was a joint of like 1970s brick weed. Like, just like, oh, this tastes nice.
Totally.
And then
I said,
looked over like, no.
He's like, Jesus, he's had that for 30 minutes. You know what I mean? The whole time I was like, how about something that's like not going to make me paranoid or feel weird? He's like, I got the thing. He's like, it's called fucking, it's like the Men in Black thing when they hold it up to your eyeballs and it just fucking erases your mind, you know? But,
Fester says he saw Jesse get contact by once.
Oh, that was on tour. That was on tour in the van with Bluebird. We were smoking some crazy shit and he came out. He's like this. He's like, what do you mean? I don't know. It was weird.
I was just sleepy.
Who is kerosene? This is amazing.
Me and Gavin, I forget where we were going, but we were going to a show.
Gavin, that's the problem right there.
We just got way too high because before we left, we were smoking at the house and we got in the cab. And when we got in the cab, I guess the guy smelled the weed and was like, hey, you can smoke weed in the cab if you want. And we were like, we were already wasted and had just smoked a blunt. And we're just like, that's cool. So we just spark up another one and just because he said so. And then by the time we got where we were going, we didn't want to be there because we were tired. But it was a show, so it was a bit of a problem, but I got through it.
He wanted the content.
Gavin's amazing, dude. Gavin's amazing.
I once got in the cab at Zafar's and they asked where I wanted to go and I said, home. Then they asked, where? And I said, I live across the street from the bank. And I couldn't see why he couldn't figure that out.
Yeah, Kier was smoking some of that shit
really
I was smoking.
A different turn.
I live near the bank too. That's tight.
Oh, cool. You should hang out sometime.
What?
I live near a snowbank, but it's not there half the year. What?
This is just like because I'm looking at my phone and my laptop back and forth, like I half think I'm on a Zoom call, and then I realize that like we're being broadcast to 3 million people in 400 countries right now.
Yeah,
yeah. Here's the thing, me and Jesse do this every night. This is just the only night we put it out there for others to see.
You should see the other night.
Yeah,
it's sharp. It's like sparring.
Yeah, basically, but every time we have a conversation that we're not broadcasting, you're like, oh, save it for the show. Every time we start to get interested in what the other person's saying, it's like, no, that'll be good for the show. And then we forget it when the actual show's on.
Yeah. Remember that time in Red Dwarf
it's a weird
when?
Year.
Yeah. It's a weird year. It's called it's a weird year. Weird.
It's a weird year.
It's a weird.
We've all been thrown off of our routines. Everybody had plans for 2020. We all thought there was stuff we were going to do. We all thought we were going to read more books. Even when things started getting weird, I thought, I was like, oh, I, at least I can like get to my books. You have any books that you've been meaning to get to lately? You just haven't made it to yet?
Yeah, hey, like, Jess.
This whole year is like meaning to get to a lot of things. But what I've gotten really good at this year is not giving myself shit for not being too productive. Still put out a lot of music because that's just like a habit and a fun escape. But as far as like reading and making art and like all these like projects that are like I really was like, here's the time to do it because like, you got the time off work. That just didn't happen. And that's kind of what. Have you guys been doing some reading?
No.
Like any title wise?
I've been reading like manuals on how to work synthesizers. That's about it.
Oh, speaking of books, James, I was telling you the other day I have that graffiti book. I bought chapters.
Yo.
I was there with my mom and you're in it. It's not, it doesn't have your name, but Os Jamios. But I couldn't, I looked through it during the whole intro to this show. I went page to page.
Let me see the cover of the book. Let me see the cover. Which one is it? Oh, fuck that one. I don't think I've fucking seen this picture yet. Yeah.
So I read chapters with my mom one time randomly. Just looking at it because I'm killing time while she's getting a book or something. And all of a sudden I'm like, oh shit, mom, it's James. And my mom knows James because we went out to Halifax like early 2000s when we recorded Sugar Cubes, when we did that show with like Pipskid, the Scratch.
Everybody. That was awesome.
Yeah, that was like the first time I was out in Halifax. So my mom knew James already because she bought us NASCAR t-shirts one day when we went on a tour of NASCAR
together,
the three of us rolling deep.
Yeah.
So she bought me this graffiti book just because I was like, yo, this is James standing under this train. Maybe even though I looked through it, I'll just open it and it's going to be that page.
Let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it.
It's not that page.
It's not.
Yo, someone in the chat say a page number.
It's Dame or Lumit, but somewhere in this big, awesome book, under a train that people are painting, James is hanging out.
Fuck.
I know I've showed it to you before, but
it sucks that
I didn't think about it till right before showtime because I could have showed it to you.
Mean Joe Toons so funny. Says page 69. Show page 69.
Of course he fucking says page 69. But Choke, what's your name on your Chokes and your Discord name is 6969, isn't it?
It's 9669. It's actually Dang. Quest.
Quest. Well, that's pretty cool. That's pretty
that's
cool.
That's content.
But,
or content. Or your content?
Yo.
Whoa.
I was saying this. The other day I was saying, like, I may not be content, but I have to make content.
Content.
You'll check out this book?
The Nothing Book.
So this book I've had since, like, I was a kid. My dad gave it to me. It's published in 1974. But, like, there's nothing. And today I checked for the first time, and there's actually no spine, so it just makes for like a good sketchbook.
But
someday I'll write my autobiography in that. Oh, yo, and check this one. I got this at a used bookstore. Sporting Times. But it says by Ian Dick. Like someone just wrote their name, Ian Dick.
Oh my God, that's dope.
But look, same thing. It's just beautifully blank.
What the fuck?
So I haven't been reading, but I'm sharing you my blank book collection.
Shout outs to fucking I Dick.
What I've been meaning to read is a book, but every one that I buy is empty.
A book I did read cover to cover. Deep Thoughts by Jack Handy.
Oh, that's dude, dope.
We'll just open the page.
Please.
And I'll just read whatever's there.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Oh, hold on.
Deep Thoughts with Jack Handy.
And now? Nice. Okay. To me, boxing is like a ballet, except there's no music, no choreography, and the dancers hit each other. And then I've also been reading Fuzzy Memories
by Jack Candy. That was me at that night at the tool shed.
Read this cover to cover. We asked Dad if we could have a trampoline, but he said no, that they were too dangerous and too expensive. But then we went and talked to the trampoline salesman at the store, and he said they weren't too expensive or dangerous. I think I'm sort of mad at Dad for lying to us like that. But as far as actual novels, all jokes aside, like an actual novel, The Stench of Honolulu by Jack Handy, which is, it's a full ass, like it's a big ass
novel. There's words on those pages.
Dude.
What'd you say?
Dope.
There's words on it. It's not just a blank book.
I know.
You it's graduated.
It's a non-blank book. But this is the best book that exists. I keep remembering when this is where it's going out to millions of people. It's so awkward.
I recently acquired. Well, Justin doesn't. He just wants to show his butt to all the people. You're going to appreciate it. Yeah, we just saw your butt. So I just got Mr. 10 Years, the by Drill. What's that say? The tiger
deep
thought. The tiger chant changes spots. No, wait, he did. Good for him.
Good for him.
So this is just a whole book of the tweets of Drill, and like,
and one goes. What? Sorry.
Well, give me a page number, and I'll tell you something that's in this book.
Dude, what about 69?
69.
Mail 1,000 envelopes addressed to the desert, and watch endless waves of government pawns march to their death. Hashtag Anarchy 2012. Hashtag Sand.
What?
FBI awesome. Deemed my tool-assisted glitch run of Mario Teaches Typing too dangerous for the public eye. The raw emotion has rendered my face purple. We both like to read books. Like, short stories is too long for me now. I just need quips.
You know what I've been doing lately? Reading...
Short stories.
I've been reading... I've been only reading mail envelopes that I receive in the mail, because now the only thing you can do is get mail in your life.
So, like, what about female envelopes? They don't make the cut?
That's what I've been saying, dude. I'm sick of this shit. Jen. I'm sick of this shit. I'm sick of this shit, man.
It's 2020, James.
I'm going to talk to the male person tomorrow about it.
The male person or the female person. It could be either one.
I'm going to get personal about it either way.
What's your book? What have you been reading? Oh, you got a present.
I got actual mail from my relatives in Australia, which might be the true Astral Island. Just saying. But Sam. How about I open it up while we listen to the next choke song, which is called Slow Clap.
This is cut from Nepotism Sessions, right? This is a Larry Bird beat?
From Nepotism, produced by Larry Bird.
That, Larry B. In the place to
it
be.
It was too good for the album was the problem with this one.
That's what I like.
So, like. That's what I like. All the record execs at our record company were like, bro, we got families. We can't, you know, we can't put this out.
Quinlan saw the chance to make millions, and he was like,
"No." He was like, "No, thank you."
Quinlan was like, "We're gonna be able to pay off fucking student debt and all this shit. Fuck that."
But
this is underground hip hop.
Shout out to Larry if he's still here.
We're going straight copper with this album. All right, can I play Slow Clap and open up a present, and then Slow Clap to it?
Yes.
Yes, all right. Please.
What up, Kira?
Is there a click track in it?
Look.
Yeah. I never leave the house, so I ain't acting street. Unless it's Michael Mann's epic classic, I ain't packing heat. Rappers acting sweet, Meryl Streep at a peak. Claiming dues are paid but can't provide the cash receipts.
Well, pardon me, your majesty. I used to give a shit, I guess that part of me is atrophy. Hardly a tragedy, there had to be some casualties. Still trying to figure out the formula for masterpiece. Unsolvable, don't call the constable. The horse that's in the hospital is doing its postdoctoral. The protocol is overall the biggest obstacle. Get fed up with bureaucracy, but never sick of popsicles. Pizza, nachos, weed, beer, and avocados.
Skateboards,
graffiti, making rap and telling bad jokes. Can't blame a motherfucker for trying. If I said I didn't believe that I'm the truth, then I'd be lying. I'd be lying if I said I didn't know the science. I learned it standing on the shoulders of giants. I'd be lying if I said I didn't know the science. I learned it standing on the shoulders of giants. Liar, liar, slow clap, slow clap. Never leave the house, yet I'm an outsider. Slam a pie in the Prime Minister's face like Mrs. Doubtfire. Used to stand out on the corner handing out flyers, competing with the Jesus freaks, dealers and the town criers. Liar, liar, I'm a whole entire tire fire. Try and fight it eye to eye, then it just rises higher. Ignited prior with the hope it might inspire writers. If I retire, I'll return more times than Michael Myers. Check the track record as we stack records. Gotta stay sharp cause they judge you on your last effort. So get your stats better for the fact checkers. Adding pressure to a system changes bad weather. Give me truth, even if it's inconvenient. Think of gleaning knowledge off of future disagreements. And kill your demons and breathe in the silence. If I said I didn't believe that I'm the truth, then I'd be lying. I'd be lying if I said I didn't know the science. Standing on the shoulders of giants. I'd be lying if I said I didn't know the science. I learned it standing on the shoulders of giants. Liar, liar, slow clap, slow clap.
Dude, what? Why is that song not on the album? That's fucking great.
Too good.
Too good.
No, thank you. I think we just made like Larry just kept sending me awesome beats and we kept making songs together. And there was a certain point where, like, I guess even though it's only 2.5 minutes more, it just, like, for what I wanted the album to be, a couple songs didn't make the cut. Fair enough. But not because, just because of tone. Like, that was kind of similar to a couple other songs, maybe in my mind as vibe. And by the end of that song, it's more serious than some of the other songs. So I think for that reason, I held it back. But then when I heard it recently, I was like, this is a lot better than I remember. And then I told Larry, hey, can I show this on the air? Let's rock and roll. And he was like, hell yeah. So shout out to Larry. Shout out not Dr. Dre. And shout out to Fester for the quits beat, which is also dope.
Yeah,
shout out to Chugs for just gracing the screen for a second there.
What happened there, little?
My heart, you know.
Yeah, that little pepperoni. Who's that baby belong to?
That's Chugs. That's one of my roommates.
Oh, I met Chugs. I hung with Chugs.
Yeah, you hung with Chugs. You guys are the same height. You see eye to eye.
I smoke nugs with Chugs.
Chugs doesn't smoke. Chugs is a sober dog.
That's what you fucking think.
You're thinking of a different dog.
Look, man, that dog smokes. Well, as soon as I arrived in Ottawa, they had the hookup. My cousin sent it in this applause thing. That's like an Australian fucking food, cat food thing or something. I don't know. It's got all those like packing things. But yo, let me open this thing up real quick. Wait, Choke, I got to ask you a question about this.
Australia?
Yeah. This is what cats eat. Right here. Dude.
Oh, another new Game Boy.
Another old Game Boy. Whoa. The screen fell off. I'll fix it.
Nope.
Dude, I'm going to mod this baby. Dude. Thanks, David. It's my cousin, David Armstrong. You're the homie. Word
up. Yo, Larry Bird Beat says, isn't there an age cap for moving to Australia?
I don't know. Is it like a hat you got to wear or something like that? An age cap?
Oh, I think before you're 30, as far as like getting a work visa or something, as far as it being easy. After you're past 30, no country wants you. No country for old men, baby.
Old men. Right, right. They don't want you to get all that health care over there. But
do they have health care? Don't they just have like poisonous animals?
DIY health care. Like...
Yeah.
Super
yeah,
DIY care. There.
Healthcare is not going to Australia.
No, nah, man. I had to get a work visa because I was in Australia right before the pandemic, which I've already discussed 1900 times on the show probably. But I was almost trapped there, which would have been kind of fun. But it was great. It was the best thing ever. Played some chiptune festivals and hung out and surfed my face off. But I never saw any crazy – I thought I was going to see crazy – I was all over the place in Australia. I never saw any – crazy spiders or never I checked my shoes every time. There was no like scorpies in there, what, you know, like nothing like that, nothing waiting to jump out at me. Yeah, it was a little bit.
They're out there looking for people who don't want to see them.
Yeah exactly. They're like, yeah, right, well, it's
no fun to get this guy.
Yeah, this guy ain't even scared. But like there was tons of lizards, so I think the lizards actually take care of a lot of that shit. So but yo, hey, Choke, I gotta ask you a question, man. In the slow clap, probably the reason you didn't put it out was because there was a line that was very similar to a song that I'm on. It's called Heat Wave. Yeah, a song about Popsicle Pete's.
What was the line?
Wasn't there a line about Popsicle Pete's?
Oh yeah. The Popsicle Pete's, but that was like a throwback to it, right?
It was. You it said was,
you never get
obviously.
Like a popsicle. Pizza nachos?
Yeah.
Does this song, oh, does I, not ring a bell?
I'm the guy who does that, and I didn't even think of Popsicle Pete until now.
It's in like there.
The things that I like is pizza, popsicles, weed, beer, avocado, graffiti. So that's what I mentioned. I never even, oh, that's crazy. The guy who
I,
the layer shit didn't
this is what happens that. When I get an episode with you. I start thinking like you, and then the next
that's
minute
wild.
We're... Yeah, but I thought it was a popsicle. As soon as you were like, "Oh, that's a song," I can't do that. You know, no, I thought it was a reference to Heat Wave. Yeah, Popsicle Pete's. Yeah, Heat Wave.
That's cool. I never realized that. But
Larry, Heat Wave is the other song. Larry's asking. You do eat a lot of popsicles. You've always eaten popsicles.
What's he asking?
Heat Wave is the song that is similar. Or has the reference. What is it? Watching Popsicle Pete's turn into...
liquidy treats.
Liquidy treat.
Melting Popsicle Pete's
into liquidy
treats.
Yeah.
Just normal hip-hop. Like, you know, it's like one of those classic rap lines. Like Biggie said it, 50 Cent said it.
Jay-Z said it. I'm not actually saying Pete's. It's just, it sounds like Popsicle Pete's. But it's
oh,
pizza.
Wow.
Well, here's the thing. But the Americanization of pizza in New Haven, Connecticut, where Chesky's from, when Chesky invented pizza, they actually call it a pizza.
He invented pizza? Is that what you said?
What are you talking about?
In New Haven, in New Haven, Connecticut, where Chesky Ramos invented American pizza, they don't call it pizza. They call it a pizza at Sal's. And
I don't know.
He told me he invented it.
Well, shout outs to Grown Up Mike. I don't know what you're talking about, Jesse, but that's cool.
He kind of sucks except the hook, Mike says. Yeah, Mike.
I don't know.
Yeah, I can't check the rhyme because I'm using my phone to talk to you guys. So I don't even remember, like...
Don't do it, Choke. Don't do it, Choke. You'll ruin the whole episode.
I'll call you back.
Yeah.
We told you to check the rhyme. It's one of our main songs.
Oh, yo, I don't even think I'm going to like this raspberry wheat ale, but I thought if it broke out into a freestyle battle, I can rhyme imaginary with the raspberry, you know what I'm saying?
That's a very word burglar inflection.
Yeah, you better watch it there.
It's like when I'm imaginary,
right,
on my skin like raspberries.
Like raspberries. Shit. Hey, dudes, it's time. It's time. We got to say peace to Choke. I got to drive Joel home before his dad gets pissed. He's our IT guy.
Speaking of pissed, you're in no condition to drive Joel home.
No, I'm doubling him on my bike. It's okay. I'm doubling him on the bike.
Let Joel drive on the way down and you drive on the way back.
Okay. Sounds good. Okay. Yeah. I'll get. Yeah. That sounds good.
So we're going to keep it on a high note. We got a special secret premiere that is upsetting people left and right. Chokes in a group called Swamp Thing. Big part of the group back burner. And Swamp Thing puts out, creates so much material, it doesn't all, it can't all squeeze through the door. And this is not only, like, this is not only a song that didn't come out, there was a whole ass video that got made.
This is a full ass premiere on the low for people who stuck around till the end of the show.
Entire bum.
Yeah, it's a, from Prey to Science 2016. Song is called Snake Oil. And we made a video for it and everything. And we just had so much goodness and heat that this was going to be part of like a teaser package or something else that wasn't the album. And it never dropped and it just never existed. And then you guys came along and said, hey, we have a show about unreleased stuff. And Timbuktu was like, what about Snake Oil? And I was like, interesting. And then we remembered there's a whole ass video. And here we are.
That's dope.
Quiet!
And here we are.
Okay, so we're going to...
These people and these people only. Hell yeah. Thanks for having me, guys. And thanks for watching me.
Choke, you've been an amazing guest. Thank you so much for hanging out. Word up to Panda. I love Panda Licorice.
And sour beer because I saw you guys talking about it on episode one. So word up. Respect.
Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Yo, thank you, everybody. Thank you, everybody, for checking us out. Thank you, everybody, for commenting and being awesome. Check us out on – we got Friday night, Larry Bird, Kira. We got the Mansta. We got the – we got everybody up in there. We got tons of homies, man. We got Grown Up Mike. We got Mean Joe Tunes. We had Fester. We had all the homies. Just got to remind you – who was that? Irate?
Irate.
Word up. Word up. Nice. Just a shout out to let you all know, Friday night we got a dope Mean Joe Tunes show on this channel where he's DJing with a special guest. And then Saturday we have our Christmas, or it's not Christmas, it's our solstice lockdown special at 3 p.m. Jesse D, thank you so much for being the awesome dude to hang with and being cool and fun. Choke, we love you. Backburner is in the building.
You.
Yeah. You're fucking awesome.
Backburner.
Swamp Thing.
Thesis Eve.
Word up.
Check out episode one, more or less. Episode two, The Mighty Rhino. Big ups to Chunks for the cameo. Big ups.
Yeah.
Word cameo for just being fun to say. Woo!
Word up.
Okay.
Word up.
Here we go. Here is the unreleased Swamp Thizzy. Love you all. Peace.
Can't wait. What does she got to do with it? Well, she's the one that's got the
bops.
Choke. Tell your cousins and your uncles and your next of kin. Sign on the dotted line. Just make the appointment. Chilling in the back. Got a cool check endorsement. Dr. Ho, rock and roll. Watch a gimmick flop. Muscles tight. Fuck it right. Get your nipple shock. Eighth grade math. But my doc is the meanest skill. Billy Mays face as I'm chopping you penis pills. Over suckers' heads as I'm drinking the Gatorade. I'm Mr. T Strong as he's pimping the flavor wave. I won't stand for a novice. Got the people yelling like I'm Kearney Thomas.
Yeah, I'm well known to evoke the devotion. Rock a tent show promoting my skin lotion. Approaching the status of a deity knockoff. Faith healing people, Peter Popoff. Old timey, rhymey solution. Rubber don't apply for your sins and ablution. I'm boosting sales, become an institution. Proof is in the pudding, but the science never proven. Yeah, I'm looking dapper on a bottle with the mustache twist in my acrobat goggles. Stack a profit with a proper boondoggle. Losing my religion like a prostitute's brothel. We stay royal, hit them with the snake oil. Make them pay, bait them so they stay loyal. We stay royal, hit them with the snake oil. Make a cake off of everything they pray for. We stay royal, hit them with the snake oil. Make them pay, bait them so they stay loyal. We stay royal, hit them with the snake oil. Make a cake off of everything they pray for.
With the remedies, cousin, I be doing all my enemies. Remedies, cousin, I'll be doing on my enemy. Remedies, doing on my enemy.
Sunglasses on my face like a mad rock. Chilling in my room, looking at my slap chop. Juices, carrots blend up with the broccoli. Got the laser light just to burn off the taco meat.
Follow me to the top of the heap, as seen on TV or hot up the street. Limited offers and impermanent products, inventing the wheel and then turning a profit.
I'm the prophet turning rubes to disciples. Back up, give me some room, I'm spitting nitro at my night show with the white robe, with the wolf fur. I appear from the smoke and the sulfur.
Door to door, still bringing the havoc. Coast to coast, demographic is massive. Fresh penny royal set to boil. But what y'all know about a Tesla coil? They sell us snake oil and fake tinctures. We got a wagon full of miracle elixirs. Ill mixtures, causing commotions. Town to town with the tonics and potions. Yo, they want mass confusion. Stay distracted, that's the blueprint. Waste your paychecks on illusions. Batteries not included.
We stay royal, hit them with the snake oil. Make them pay, bait them so they stay loyal. We stay royal, hit them with the snake oil. Make a cake off of everything they pray for. We stay royal, hit them with the snake oil. Make them pay, bait them so they stay loyal. We stay royal, hit them with the snake oil. Make a cake off of everything they pray for.
This is the Flavor Wave Turbo Oven.
This is the cook?
This is the cook.
I love it when a plan comes together, darling. Mmm.
I think you're still broadcasting.